Tess had a dream. Now Rachel has a dream. And what can Heather dream? They'll think I'll back down and just cow. When I mention obesity, they say I lack brain power. They run away as much as the Eiffel Tower. Like sour patch kids, they speak the name sound. What's going on? It's your boy, what can I change? Yes, they say, man, just stay in your lane. You're insane in the membrane. You're doing this every day. I am doing this daily. But they say I am crazy, cause I want them to play with their daughter and son. If they live in this life, then their life is done. I'm just trying to get you going for a few more years. But y'all eating everything in sight, I upstairs. But you know you can't do this every single day. Y'all thinking this is cool and obesity is a game. Nope, that's not the thing. That is the name of the game. And I come in here, but I gotta stay in my own lane. Not today. Alright, I'm just playing, guys. What's going on? It's your boy, what can I change? AKA Lockjaw. Let's get into this video. So we're gonna be watching Rachel. We're gonna be watching Rachel. She's the one you've probably seen in Fatopia at the very beginning. I'll show you that short little clip here.
Woo! I do not owe you thinness. I am.
So that's her. So that's these videos we're going to be enjoying today. We're gonna watch a few of her videos and see how they go. The only part of her videos I've seen is that one you guys just saw a clip of. So we're gonna see how she thinks. Now these videos of hers are one is from a month ago, one is from a year ago, one is from about that same time. So she is still that big. Nothing has changed. She still speaks that way. So this is all still relevant. Let's go ahead and see what she has to say.
The old joke goes, patient walks into the doctor's office, says, "Doctor, it hurts when I move my arm like this. What should I do?" And the doctor says, "So don't move your arm like that." Now, fat girl walks into doctor's office, says, "Doctor, it hurts when I move my arm like this. What should I do?" And the doctor says, "Have you considered weight loss surgery?" Fat girl walks into the doctor for a flu shot and gets a lecture about BMI. Fat girl walks into the doctor's with an earache and gets asked if she's ever eaten a salad. Fat girl walks into the doctor's office with a spider bite, and the doctor obsesses over how low her blood pressure is. Low for such a fat person anyway. Insists on checking it 3 times before he'll believe it. Forgets completely about the mass of purple spider venom that brought her here to begin with. Fat girl walks into the doctor's to ask about antidepressants and gets prescribed exercise instead, because obviously her depression is because of her fat, and obviously fat bodies never exercise and stay fat. Fat girl walks into the doctor's office for a standard 3-month follow-up appointment, and the doctor says, "Have you considered that weight loss surgery yet?"
Yo. Oh my gosh, when has that happened? What is that? You walked into there, had a spider bite, you now know they're just making up situations. But come on now, you walk in there with a spider bite on your eye, and your eye is literally falling out of its socket. They're gonna go, "Have you considered that weight loss surgery?"
You're dying. You have crippling depression. Have you considered weight loss surgery?
Whatever, man. You know how I feel.
Fat girl gets tired of constantly being diagnosed as fat. So Fat Girl stops walking into the doctor's office. Fat Girl walks into the world and says, "World, it hurts to exist like this." And the world says, "So stop existing like that." Fat Girl walks through a world that would rather she slice herself open than to exist as she does. Side effects be damned. Fat Girl walks through a world overrun with sidewalk doctors who claim to be concerned about her health. Side effects be damned. Fat Girl walks into the world and still somehow manages to love her fat body. And the world says, "Stop glorifying obesity." Fat Girl walks into the world and says, "I do not owe you shrinking, you know. I do not owe you thinness, attempted thinness, or desired thinness, because you assume thinness equals health. For that matter, I do not owe you health, perceived or otherwise, to receive basic respect. I am deserving of care. I am deserving to exist as I do. I am deserving of first, no harm done." And the world says, "That is the best joke we've heard all day."
You just make me laugh. "I do not owe you thinness." She said, I do not owe you health. That you get the same health deservance that anybody. You are. Are you not? She's going off the whole notion that you can walk into a doctor's office and have the worst thing going on with you, and then bam, the doctor's going to be like, "You're fat though. Let's just speak about you being fat. I'm not going to use any of my other medical profession in my life. I'm only going to tell you you're fat. So good luck to you. Peace. Where you at, people? I need to see some recordings. I need to see some evidence. Because I'm obese. And I never walk into a doctor's office. I remember my tooth was decaying, right? So I had a back tooth back here that had gotten infected. And you know, when I went to the doctor and said I had tooth pain, you know what he said? "Well, your tooth might be decaying. Here, we'll give you this medicine and you should go see a dentist." And so I go to see the dentist. You know what the dentist said? "Hey, you have a tooth that's decaying, you know. We can go ahead and get that out for you." I just wanted to pause, you know, just so y'all could put that together. He never mentioned how fat I was, not once. When I called originally, I called the ambulance because I couldn't figure out what was going on, you know, and I didn't have a vehicle or anything at the time, so I just called. And so, and you know what they said? They didn't get to me and be like, "Well, have you thought about it? What you ate? You know, are you probably, you'd probably be fat, you know? It might just be because you're fat." No, they didn't do all that. They took me to the doctor, led me to the dentist. I got that tooth pulled. Here we are today, my friend. But no, it happens to all of us. I'm crazy. Anyway, next.
It always begins with the kind of stare I can feel, as though the sun itself is trying to render my body to flame. Then the attempt to catch my elusive eye, followed by the questions of my availability. I radiate disinterest so hard, I pulsate. And still, inevitably, the lean in and the whisper comes. But I like big women. As though the password to a speakeasy, and I should open up and serve him all of my unlicensed and intoxicating wares. as though my no was due not to indifference, but to the certainty that this prince of public transit could not possibly be interested in me, massive me. He likes big women, and yet has not been thrown a parade. Attention, passengers of the number 2 eastbound Main Street bus. This man likes big women.
I have one thing I want to say on that. So there's a time, you know, we've all done online dating and that kind of stuff. So when you get on online dating, there's times where you come across women who are bigger. And you know, when I've read the bios and stuff, I always get, if you don't like big women, move along, swipe left. But it's funny that she's talking about it as if it's a big deal. Like, why should we even mention it? You know, like, I should be throwing a parade because I like big women by just coming out and saying it. But yet, when I come across big women, they make a big deal about the fact that they're big women, as if I don't like big women, I'm not worthy. You know, like, if you don't like big women, swipe left, I'm not for you. It's just kind of like, okay, so you didn't even allow me to even... You didn't put yourself out there to get to know your personality or anything. You just said because you're a big woman and because I don't like you, I got to swipe left. I don't even deserve your time. You know what I'm saying? It's just, that's how I feel. It's just like, well, I mean, just because you're big, like in my head, I'm like, just because you're big, you know, you could possibly be dropping weight right now or anything. But you're saying you're big, swipe, forget me, you ain't worth my time. Just something to think about.
He likes big women, so I should take off my giant panties, fall to my fat knees on this very bus, and service him. He likes big women, and that is more important than my comfort. Tell me, what are the odds that I, a big woman, get on a city bus with this man who likes big women? The stars are aligning in my favor. 3 cheers for the knight who wants the castle despite her princess. Let us take this bus to the end of the line and start a new life. Where I will birth his children. And when they ask wide-eyed, Mommy, how did you know that Daddy was the one? I can say, well, he boldly fought through my personal boundaries while I was just trying to fucking get home from work. And he told me that he likes big women. As though this isn't the subtlest way to say, take who will have you, because who else will possibly want you like that?
I mean, oh my gosh. I don't know exactly what he did. Maybe if he just bursted through everybody and said, hey, I like big women. Now, if he did something like that, that'd be kind of weird. But if the real conversation was more like, you're on the city bus, he's talking to you, you're having a conversation, or he just says, hey, you know, I like big women. You know, he just kind of gives you that slight. That's still kind of creepy to me. But my only issue with it, and I get where she's coming from, as if he's saying that you should take me just because you're big. I get that, because, you know, just because you're a bigger person doesn't mean I have to settle for just what comes my way. But in the case, that does happen. Some people are willing to get to know you. Some people are willing to get past that. For me, like I said, like, big women don't bother me. You're like, if you're showing some progress and trying to do that, fine. But if you give me the attitude of, oh, I'm fine the way I am, I'm not going to change, then it's kind of like, well, no. You know, I wouldn't do that for any woman, you know. If you're just willing to stay where you're at, I don't know if I want that. So, I don't know. They're making it seem as if that is the case. Like, only... if a person comes up to you and says, I like big women, that you should, you know, be excited. Like, thank God somebody can finally notice me. But that's just not the attitude I get a lot. That's just not the attitude I get a lot. I don't meet women who are bigger who have that attitude a lot. The women I meet that are bigger, most of the time have the, well, I'm a BBW, if you don't like it, swipe. Or if, you know, just, I am big and I love it. You know, I am curvy and I love it. So they make it more coming out. They put that in the bio before I even know who they are. You know, so that's what comes out a lot. And then the bigger people you meet in public, you know, that you talk to and stuff like that, maybe you don't get it as much because that would be kind of weird if you walked up to somebody in public and said, hey, my name is Trey. And they go, well, I'm big. And if you don't like it, walk along. I mean, it'd be kind of weird. And that's the same thing if I just walked up to a girl and said, I like big women. I mean, here's the thing, though. I mean, that kind of goes both ways because I've had girls who walked up to me and tell me, just one girl just walked up to me and said, you're fine. And it's just kind of like, well, that's creepy statement. I've had girls walk up on me, you know, touch me. If you guys know, I'm not a huge fan of being touched, you know. I don't mind people touching me who are my friends, but somebody who just likes to touch all the time, it just drives me nuts. So I get where she's coming from, but that's just not the attitude I come across, Miss Rachel.
She says she simply can't have any French fries. Her thin arm slithering across the table, pulling a few from my plate. She can have everything she wants without ever looking like a beast.
All right, guys, I have to switch up the camera a little bit because the sun is coming down, so I'm trying to give you all this because it's really bright down here. Okay, let's start with this first of all. So the skinny girl can eat whatever she wants without becoming a beast. No, she can't. Just because you're obese does not mean that anybody who eats like you means that they can't become obese as well. That's just not true. I have thought the same thing. I remember when I used to watch people eat like pizza and stuff like that. I'm like, oh, but I eat pizza and she eats pizza. So how come I'm fat? She's not. Because Trey, you eat much more than she does. Just because you caught her eating a pizza once does not mean she eats pizza every day of her life. Okay? I had the same thing with my best friend. He was in really great shape. And he, when we were together, he ate a lot more than me. But all the time, he was, at the same time, he was very active. I mean, very. He worked out on his yard all the time, all day. He ran. He worked out. He did a lot of things that I did not do. I would sit at home and play video games. When he was outside moving things, you know, outside working, he worked for a company that built those inflatables. He'd be doing that for, 10 hours a day, just moving those big old things around. I was sitting at home, but yet, just because he built up an appetite sometimes, it's all mean he ate quite a bit, does not mean that we are on the same level. She can't just eat whatever she wants and not be a beast. Let's sit us both down. I want to see you and that girl sit down. And let's just go throughout y'all's whole, this is take a year. We'll just see what y'all eat for a year. Guarantee it will not be the same.
Without looking like me. I made them look so good. She couldn't resist. She will lick the warm salt from her lips and it will be something like seductive. One time, I dared to eat an apple at a bus stop. Honey crisp, slightly chilled. And a car veered across two lanes of traffic to splash my fat body with shame.
All right, guys, so I had to switch because the sunlight is getting in. But let me say this. I want you to type about this comment. In the comments, put exactly what you think about that statement. I think that if that really happened, people are jerks. You know, but that's not the narrative she's pushing. Okay, the narrative she has pushed was that a skinny girl can lick salt off their lips. A skinny girl can lick salt off their lips and it's kind of seductive and, you know, stuff like that. And it's perfectly okay because they can eat whatever they want without becoming obese. But at the same time, for her, she eats an apple and then gets splashed in the face. So she's pretty much saying, if you're fat, there's really no way of winning. Even if you try to live a healthier life. Not that she is, because she's not trying to.
But if you're trying to live a healthier life, that people are still going to hate you. So why? That's where the whole love yourself comes from, really, right? Because it's like, even if I eat an apple, people still hate me. So if I eat bad, they make fun of me. If I eat good, they make fun of me. So I need to learn how to just love myself where I'm at. But, you know, like I've always said, those people are jerks. So somebody who comes out of the way to do that, come on now. Somebody veering two lanes to splash your body, come on now. That would be an absolute jerk. But that does not mean society within itself is saying, oh, if you're healthy, you're trash. You know, and like I said before, and I'll go ahead and mention this. This is why I'm not a big fan of the channels that make fun of people who are fat, you know, meaning that they're trying to get across an agenda, but they're doing it in a, not the best way to me. Like if a girl's talking about thin privilege, a fat girl's talking about thin privilege, and then you go out of your way to make the video about her and they'd be like, but some fat whale talked about having thin privilege. No, you fat B word. What you need to do is eat a little less, okay? It's not my fault that you're fat. You know, that's going out of the way to me. And I try never to do that. But at the same time, it has to be two sides of the street. You're making it seem as if everybody hates you just because you're trying to eat healthy. We got to find a happy medium here, you know? Type your comments below.
When she ran away from dinner to chase the sparkle of her own collarbones, she was lovingly coaxed back to eating. A prodigal prom queen returned to a gown that never came in plus size anyway. I still sometimes curl myself around hunger, still sometimes refuse to eat. Let the hunger rattle through me, a train I might at least get to ride into lightness. But hunger never made me his girl. No matter how sweet I begged him to stay. Hunger loves me, same as so many men, pants half on, same men who have wives and daughters at home counting carbs, never once suspecting that I am her father's fat mistress. When she tucks and pins my stretched skin to fit around her small frame, it'll be something like courageous. Right? The still wet spit from angry mouths when I wore it, suddenly diamond sparkle. She is a Cinderella story. I, the fat gourd she arrives in. It's not her fault. I made it look so good.
Okay, that ending might have been a little bit confusing, so it's, you know, it's always left up to interpretation, stuff like that for poetry. So pretty much, when she's talking about husbands going home to their wives and her being the fat mistress, she's still talking about, you know, the father that she's talking about is still hunger. So hunger goes home and does other things with, you know, their lives, but she will always be the side girl because she cannot starve herself and the hunger can, she can't live with that hunger. She can't be with hunger. She can't just live in that because hunger will never make her his girl. So she'll never be with that. She'll only be his mistress. Every now and then getting to mess around with hunger. Every now and then trying but never getting to that point. And then the ending about pretty much a skinny girl being in a fat body. You know, she wants to be all these things. But at the same time, she ends up being, she's still big, you know, because she made it look so good. So she's trying to be the skinny girl she can't, you know. So when she puts on this skin, when she puts on this big body, skinny girl putting in a big body, you know, she shows up and stuff like that. That's why she misses the prom dress, not coming in plus size anyway, you know. So she's trying to be the skinny girl in a fat girl's body. But she, like she said, she can only be the mistress to hunger. So she can't quite get there. So here she is. That's what I got out of it. Here's my thing about you, my friend Rachel Wiley. You know, you're making it seem like, and this is always my issue, is people try to play to your emotions, right? When you're obese, some people will just say all these things to be like, but I try, but I cannot do it. Because when I try, the world comes at me and says, you shut your fat mouth. When I go to the gym, people stare at me as if, why is she here? Is the treadmill even going to move? When she stands up on it, she should just go back home. And when I, and so it kind of gives you that kind of feel. Like you're feeling bad for the person who's fat. So they can stay fat and nobody will ever say anything to them. But at the same time, I'm not going to let you slide with that, Miss Rachel. You still need to work out for your health. You need to work out your health is what I mean. You got to find a way to eat the right nutrition. You got to find a way to make those things happen. And you're not a bad person, Rachel. But at the same time, it looks like you kind of fell into that victim mentality of, well, everybody hates me because I'm fat because I always get picked on. And yeah, that sucks. You're right. And just cause, and even if you lose weight and people are nicer to you, don't get caught up in that either. But that does not mean that you shouldn't do something better for your health. Forget those people. People are jerks, you know? Girls have laughed in my face. Girls have still made fun of me. I've had girls just straight up, you know, like I said, you go through the dating things and the dating apps and you show a girl your picture and she never speaks to you again because she saw your body. I get all that. But at the same time, this is not about looking pretty. This is not about having everybody love you. This is about saving your life and this is about health. Once you get that concept, Rachel, and quit and forget about what people really think, because people are going to hate Rachel. Even if you get smaller, they'll find something to hate about you. That's just how it is. If you ever watched Dr. Seuss, you remember the little green guys with the bellies? So there were some green guys who had stars on their bellies, and there were some green guys who did not have stars on their bellies, right? So even though these two people looked exactly the same, some, you know, they pretty much all look the same except for some had stars on their belly and some didn't. Separation still happened. Division still happened. People still hate it. Rachel, somebody's always going to hate you for some reason. But that does not mean that you should use your fatness as a stick it to the man. I'm going to love myself as I am and forget you. That's not where you should go. You should look for your health first. And then once you get all the weight off and all that stuff and you get healthier, nothing should change, Rachel. You're still you. You're still beautiful. You're still more than that. You know, you're still more than just your weight. But at the same time, you know, people out here love you and want to see you lose the weight. We're not defining you by just your weight, but at the same time, you know, you gotta do better, you know. And I know, and that's why I give the tough love, you know. That's why I don't let you get away with saying certain statements, you know, because I don't want you to stay in this victim mentality, okay? You probably never, you know, if you ever see this, Rachel, know that I'm not, I don't care that you're fat. I care about your health. And I hope you get to do better. Now for you guys, hope you enjoyed the video. Hope you have a good one. Like I said, type down in the comments about that Apple comment. I mean, just that part. Just let me know what you think about that. You know, well, obviously you can comment about whatever you want to, but let me know what you think about that. Just because I think that one was a real heart tugger. You know, that's what you try to do. The whole point of, I can get into this, but the whole point of an argument is not to win, it's not to fight with people. It's to win over the audience. So anybody who's sitting in that audience, let's say I was sitting in the audience and there's a bunch of people around me, who do you think won? If there's a bunch of people like me who are against obesity and stuff like that, and there's people who are like on the fence, who do you think won? Like, who do you think won? Me? You know? Like me sitting in the audience, you think my type of people, even though we're against it, do you think we could be persuaded? Obviously so, because people like me, well, probably not like me, but I'm trying to figure out what I'm trying to say here. Like, if you got two people here, right? You got one cat, you got another cat, okay? I'm trying to argue against obesity, and then you just got random people scattered throughout the audience. So there's me there, and let's say I get up on stage and talk my stuff, and then she talks, she's probably going to win the audience by just emotionally getting them invested. What I would have to do is tell my story the same way and then tell it opposite, you know? So she's very good at getting people to pretty much feel sorry for her. And so allowing her to stay big, and that the world is the enemy, but that's not the truth. That's not a good enough reason. Anyway, I can stay on that all day. Guys, I hope y'all have a blessed, blessed day. Anything you want me to comment on, let me know. Share this video. I hope y'all have a blessed, blessed day. And peace.